Die Lage in der Eurozone ist noch immer kritisch. Deshalb diskutieren Politiker und Ökonomen über den richtigen Weg aus der Krise. Welche Maßnahmen führen dauerhaft zu einer besseren Wirtschaftslage? Und wie kann die europäische Integration stärker vorangetrieben werden? Antworten auf diese Fragen geben Marcel Fratscher, Jean Pisani-Ferry und Jörg Rocholl während einer Diskussion in Berlin. Im Laufe der Podiumsdiskussion wird auch das neue Buch von Jean Pisani-Ferry vorgestellt: The Euro Crisis and Its Aftermath.
Welcome to the presentation of Jean Pisani-Ferry's book, The Euro Crisis in the Aftermath. This is the copy of the book. Jean did a very good job in actually summarizing what has happened in the last 6 years during the European crisis. So it's an excellent overview about where we stand, and it also provides some insight or some ideas how we could continue or solve the euro crisis in the future.
All of the nations, all of the countries, all of the national governments contributed, made domestic policy mistakes that contributed in an essential way to the crisis, including Germany, by the way.
We still have a financially fragile situation because of the high debt level and because of the non-completely repaired financial integration. So there is a lot ahead of us.
To get the narrative right between solidarity and reforms, it is important that the solidarity comes with losses taken by those who took the risks, so that taking risks comes with taking losses, something that we've seen far too little. But that is relevant for a Europe that remains relevant, and in particular for which institutions, citizens in particular, feel pride and feel sympathy.
What was underestimated was the depth of the problem with private debt and with the banking system. And so that's a lesson that somehow there is a tendency, because it's based on the treaty, to overestimate what has to do with fiscal consolidation and to underestimate what has to do with the state of the financial system and private debt.
I think the ECB has taken, in my view, a very courageous step. I have serious doubts that the ECB will manage to solve the problem. I think there are two big problems for the ECB. One is what we described, that the liquidity it gives to banks doesn't reach companies and private households in particular in crisis countries. I think we need to solve the banking problem. I think this is, to me, the key to really solve this monetary transmission to the private sector. So from that perspective, I'm rather pessimistic, and I think the deflationary pressure will be a big drag on the European economy in the years to come.
So we really need to get the capital that really can go into high-risk investments. I welcome all the opportunities to go more in this direction, to think about a transparent, clear market for equity investments in which there's also an exit strategy later on.